Question 1. What is Cobit and what does it stand for? Answer. Cobit is an acronym for Control Objectives for Information and Related Technology. ISACA created this framework for the governance and management of IT. Question 2. What is ISACA and what does it stand for? Answer. It was initially called the Information Systems Audit and Control Association. It is a global non-profit association that develops, adopts practices and knowledge which are accepted universally for information systems. Question 3. What is the history of ISACA? Answer. It was formed in the year of 1969 and it was run by a small circle of individuals who realized that there was a need for a source of guidance and information in the then upcoming field of computer systems control of auditing. But now it serves various professionals. As of now, ISACA has 140,000 and more constituency which is present worldwide, and it is known for its diversity. These constituents are known to work and live in not less than 108 countries and take up most of the positions related to IT. This position includes the Chief Information Officer, IS Auditor, Internal Auditor, IS Security Professional, Regulator etc. Some can be new in the field but most of them are at the ranks of the seniors. They are known to work in most of the categories in any of the industries which includes utilities, manufacturing, public and government sector, finance and banking etc. Question 4. What is Cobit used for? Answer. It is used by the people who have certain responsibilities regarding the processes of the business and its technology. The information needs to be reliable and relevant and it must have some quality and control of the information being provided as well as that of technology. Question 5. Why was Cobit 5 developed? Answer. There were several reasons for the development of Cobit 5. There was a necessity for a business which covers the entire functions of IT and business. There was an utmost need for organization of the information and dissemination of the information which was concerned with the framework. There was a need to integrate Cobit with other recommendations, frameworks and researches of ISACA. Question 6. What are the certain components which are included in Cobit? Answer. The components included in Cobit are the framework, the process descriptions, the control objectives, the management guidelines and the maturity model. In the framework, the basic idea is to organize the good practice and governance of IT by its domains and processes and link them to the requirements of the business. In control objectives, there is a list of requirements which are to be measured by the management for efficient control of various processes of IT. The maturity models assess the maturity and the capabilities and address redressal regarding any gaps. Question 7. How prescriptive are the Cobit maturity models and supporting guidance, and how does this compare to the CMMI approach? Answer. The MMs in Cobit, like all the Cobit guidance, are intended to be tailored and developed to suit the specific needs of the enterprise. The guidance is also at a high level with the intention that it provides generic guidance, not specific, detailed criteria. In particular, the maturity attributes are very generic and high level, intended to be a simple guide for any process. When performing a Cobit maturity assessment, specific attribute details will need to be identified for the process under review, and compared to Cobit's control objectives, control practices, and goals and metrics to the desired level of detail. Cobit does not prescribe the assessment approach, which is a management decision, ranging from a high-level workshop discussion to an in-depth analysis, as appropriate, driven by business need. In CMMI, although the guidance would always need to be tailored for a given appraisal situation, the standard guidance is much more specific and detailed, due to its much narrower focus on software product delivery and more formal appraisal assessment procedure. Question 8. Why do you think one should use Cobit 5? Answer. The framework provided by Cobit provides utmost benefits and breadth unlike any other framework. It helps in maintaining high level of information to provide the needed support for any decisions regarding business, and it also helps in achieving the strategic set goals through innovative and effective usage of the IT. It also helps in attaining optimal cost of the technology and services provided by the IT. Question 9. Has the Cobit framework been accepted by CIOs? Answer. Yes, it has been accepted in many organizations globally, and new cases continue to be documented. However, it should not surprise anyone that in those entities where the CIO has embraced Cobit as a usable IT framework, this has come as a direct consequence of one or more Cobit champions within the audit and or IT department. Even more important than accepting acceptance by the CIO is acceptance by the board and executive management. Successful implementation of IT governance using Cobit depends greatly on the commitment of top management. The addition of the management guidelines should also increase the acceptance of Cobit by enterprise and IT management. The emphasis on alignment of IT with enterprise goals, self-assessment and performance measurement will ensure that Cobit is seen not only as a control framework, but also is providing a set of tools for improving the effectiveness of information and IT resources. The integration of the management guidelines with the Cobit framework and control objectives provide additional emphasis for management to use Cobit as the authoritative, up-to-date and established model for IT control and governance. Question 10. Is the Cobit framework superior to the other accepted control models? Answer. Most senior managers are aware of the importance of the general control frameworks with respect to their fiduciary responsibility, such as COSO, Cadbury, COCO or King II. However, they may not necessarily be aware of the details of each. In addition, management is increasingly aware of the more technical security guidance such as ISO 17799 and service delivery guidance such as ITIL. Although the aforementioned models emphasize business control and IT security and service issues, only Cobit attempts to deal with IT-specific control issues from a business perspective. It should be noted that COSO was used as source material for the business model and ISO 17799 and ITIL, amongst many others, were used to develop the control objective. Cobit is not meant to replace any of these control models. It is intended to emphasize what control is required in the IT environment while working with and building on the strengths of these other control models. Question 11. What is the level of training required? Answer. The amount and level of training necessary is a function of how comfortable one feels with the product. However, practical experience has shown that successful implementation is directly related to the amount of Cobit knowledge acquired. Therefore, training is considered to be very important, but the training also has to be properly and correctly provided, which is why ISACA developed a portfolio of courses. The IT Governance Implementation Guide, Using Cobit and Val IT, 2nd edition, and the IT Assurance Guide provide valuable support following attendance at training courses. Question 12. What are the differences between the Cobit 5 and Cobit 4.1? Answer. Cobit 5 clearly differentiates between management and governance. It also calls for different dimensions and inputs to the regime of the governance. Cobit 5 also incorporates the different frameworks that were developed by ISACA. Question 13. Explain about the version Cobit 4.1. Answer. It is a framework of governance and a tool of support that allows the participants to bridge the distance between any issues of technicality, risks involved in business and the requirements of control.